Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I want to show you how to make seamless patterns in Illustrator using the pattern tool. This Illustrator tutorial is only for Illustrator CS6 and CC. If you have Illustrator CS5 or older, you should check out my other seamless pattern tutorial. So open Illustrator and let's get started. Create a new document and give it a new name. I'm going to start with an artboard that's 6x6 inches. In RGB color and at 300 pixels per inch. Click Create to continue. I have here a few floral illustrations that I'm going to use for this pattern. These were hand-drawn, scanned and digitized using Illustrator. If you want to follow along, you can download this winter flower sample pack from my website. Just click the image description and follow the link, unzip the file and you can extract the Illustrator files. I'm going to select everything using the selection tool. Then I'm going to press Ctrl+C to copy them and Ctrl+V to paste them in my new document. So now that I have my elements, I can start making the pattern. I'm going to start by adding the branches and after that I'm going to add some of the filler elements like berries and leaves. I want to create a random repeating pattern, so the branches are scattered around the artboard. Some of them are even outside the artboard, but keep in mind that it's important to have them inside the artboard, so they should at least touch the artboard, even if they are something like this. Now I have this white space around the items and I'm going to fill it with some of the smaller elements like the berries and leaves. When you are happy with the design, delete the rest of the elements and then use the selection tool to select everything. I'm not going to add a background for this pattern yet because it doesn't always work well with the pattern tool. So just select all the elements and then go to Object, Pattern, Make. This will bring out the pattern tool. So let's take a look at the options. You can give your pattern a new name. I'm going to call it Winter Flowers. You can choose from one of the 5 tile types. I am going to leave grid for this pattern, but the others also look great and you can make many different patterns using them. Then here we have the width and height of our pattern tile. Now I want the pattern tile to be the same size as the artboard. That's because I want to be able to save it as a tileable JPEG or EPS file, so I need to know the dimensions of my pattern. So I'm going to enter 6 inches for the width and 6 inches for the height of the pattern. If you want to go back to the original size, just click on the size style to art button and it will go back. So let's make it 6x6 again. Down here we also have a few options. The copy refers to the number of copies of our pattern tile. Then dim copies, if you choose to make them 70% for example, it will lower the opacity of your copies so you can see the main pattern over here. So I usually keep it somewhere around 50%. And also you have this option to show the tile edge. I think it's better to show it because you can see the edges and it's easier to arrange the item. Because I made the pattern tile smaller, some of the elements are overlapping, like this branch over here. So you'll have to rearrange them or even delete them. I think I'm going to delete this element. Now, if you move the elements outside the tile area, the element won't appear in your pattern. If you add it inside, it doesn't matter where we add it, you can see that a copy of the element appears here. So for now, I'm going to leave some of the elements outside the tile area and rearrange the large branches. When you want to test your pattern, just dim the copies to 100%, then use the hand tool to move around. What you are looking for are areas where items overlap, or where items are cut off, or maybe very large white spaces. I can probably spend hours just tweaking a pattern, but I want to keep this tutorial short, so I'm going to save it even if it's not quite done yet. So when you're happy with your pattern, just click Done to save. Just a quick tip, if you want your pattern tile to be a certain size, you can use the rectangle tool. Make sure it has no fill and no stroke, and then create a pattern that's the size you want. So I'm going to go with 6 by 6 inches like my artboard, and then I am going to align it to the artboard, and I'm also going to send it to the back. So now I'm going to use the selection tool to select everything. Make sure your rectangle is selected, and then go to Object, Pattern, Make. As you can see now, our pattern tile is 6 by 6 inches. When you create a pattern using the pattern tool, a pattern swatch will appear here in the swatches panel. If you can see the swatches panel, you can open it from Window and Swatches. So I'm going to select the pattern swatch and then go back to the rectangle tool, and I'm going to create a rectangle that's 6 by 6 inches. Let's switch back to the selection tool. Now this rectangle is a seamless pattern tile. So if you make a copy of the pattern, you can see that it repeats seamlessly. So I'm going to delete this, and I want to add a background to this pattern. You can see it because I have a white artboard, but it doesn't have a background. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this rectangle using the command Control C, and then I'm going to paste it in the back using the command Control B. If you take a look at the layers panel, you can see that we have two rectangles here. Now this rectangle in the back is selected, so I'm going to change its color to this off-white. Now I am going to select both of them, and I am going to go to Object, Expand. This will expand the pattern swatch, and I'm going to make sure both of them are selected again and go to the Pathfinder tools. If you can't see them, you can go to Window, Pathfinder, and then I'm going to click on Crop. So now I have a group here that I am going to move to the swatches panel, or let's go back to Object, Pattern, Make. You can click on it and drag it to the swatches panel. So as you can see now, we have a pattern that has a colorful background. So just click Done to save it. Now I can delete this, and let's use the rectangle tool to draw a large rectangle. So this is our pattern without a background, and this is our pattern with a background. You can add many backgrounds to it, just make sure to expand it and then use the Pathfinder tools to crop it. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop and Illustrator tutorials, please visit my blog or subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!